Everything okay now? I fixed it now. The chat must be a little bit behind. No, it's not the I2, no. I just had my rear hanger adjusted, which has just happened in the most recent video I uploaded about an hour ago. So yeah, it's made a world of a difference. Not had to change anything, just adjusted the rear mech of the hanger. I always choose the Tron Jordan. Only because of what has happened in the past. I've watched some of the Giro dads, yeah. How's everybody doing, Emmy? Sorry, I've been ignoring you the last couple of minutes. I guess you could still pick up the headwind. Cheers, Grim. Yeah, it's a good course, this one. Full of excitement, this course. Short, sharp, two climbs, and it doesn't finish on the climb either, so. Bit of excitement. Should be done in just over half an hour. Eating pumpkin soup. Okay. Which bike am I on? Do you mean in the game or in real life? Same bike, Gus. But I had the rear hanger. The rear mech hanger is a little bit twisted because I keep taking the bike on and off to get it onto here, and obviously I was getting in and out of the car, so just adjusted the alignment of the rear mech and it's like a brand new bike. Easy, really. Of course we're going for the win. I call Nago. No. To 4C, Gus, to 4C. My hill climbing bike. I know, community league starts like a week today, does it? We up for that. We up for that. Hey, how you doing? Yes, Leo. Don't survive very long with me. Or at least the chains don't. Anyway, changing the chain in about 2 weeks. Because it's almost worn out after 2 months already, so. Oh, man. Time up the kill is going well, Johan. We're up to like 70 seconds of it, so not bad. No, the community league is for, well, the community. The Premier League, Damon, is for the big boys. Hey Lewis! Just in time to Zwift race this season. What time is the pitch ride? Didn't even know there was one. Is he live streaming? It must be. Okay, here we go. First volcano rep coming up. See how... Oh no, maybe not. Oops. Nice one, Chris. Good old Donnie Chain Gang. The hardest ride on Zwift. Nice one, Lord. Plug it real good. Thank you, Johan. By the way, I bet the mic sounds better up here now, doesn't it? You should probably spin it down more than I do, Tim. God, strung out early. Thank you, Grim. We're always trying to improve things over here. What I love about this course is how short a recovery you get between the two climbs. No, I'm not Ollie. I didn't even know about it, to be honest. Good though. Good that he's got a little ride together, because he probably needs the motivation to get going again, which is no bad thing. No bad thing at all. It's a great way to get the group together. So I'm thinking I'm saving this forever, probably. Man, it is very quiet, isn't it? I know. Welcome to the club. It doesn't get any easier, does it? Oh yeah, warm, yeah. Oh. Right on. Kind of Welshman in this group. T. Williams. Big group there. Sounds good. Just so you know, I've got loads of capacity in that heart rate to go. It feels like nothing at the minute. 165 beats a minute feels like nothing. So bear that in mind when you look at the max heart rate tonight. I think it's going to be a lot more than usual. Watts is like middle zone 3, middle to slightly lower zone 3. Well, my FTP is not quite as strong as it was because I'm obviously focusing on something else now. Thank you, Vegan. Possibly, Gus, yeah. Thank you, Vegan Traffy. That's really appreciated. Well, the idea there was actually to see if we can stretch a couple of people. I don't think they wanted to go, so. But it also allowed me to open myself up, so. Like, I need like a fairly good warm-up. I am warmed up, really, so that was like a good ramp and then a bit of a dig over the top. And what you'll probably notice already is that, like, I was doing a 500 watt set, like orange numbers now feel like a lot easier, but not easier. I just feel like, you know, if I'm going like hard, I used to drop in and out of orange numbers. And now when I go hard, I feel like I'm in orange numbers. It's just something I picked up on. Even Phil, just saw you do your race, buddy. Well, I caught a bit of it, is what I'm saying. Not much rest now, guys. Till the next time. Oh. Chris Beck says, I'm not working unless we cooperate. Interesting. I thought nobody works anyway. at LOTTA. I remember LOTTA from my racing days, when I first started racing in the UK. Strong riders, LOTTA. LOTTA's a brandy. Yeah, nice one, Phil, nice one. It's a lot of recovery there. See a couple of people pedaling. Oh, how else do you pedal to Nils? You can't get it wrong, can you? If you want to speak Dutch on Discord next week, we can do it. I'm kidding, by the way, I don't know any Dutch. Chosen. It does sound a little bit awesome, doesn't it? 13k to go. Our little group isn't that far back. Just 13, 12 seconds. Here we go. Back into the heat. Going on over on Chris streams, he started already. And an off season? I don't know. I don't know. If I don't ride the Nationals, Tom, I'm going to be chomping it a bit. Like, all this training and then no event, like, so. I don't think there's a Welsh name for that. I suggest you all stick around for this rather than going on with the Critch's stream. I'm joking, you can go wherever you want. This would be quite easy for this group. This effort right now, so I imagine this volcano is going to be pretty hard, as most of us are pretty fresh. Have you had the entry accepted, Tom? I'm guessing you have. I had mine accepted today. Oh, someone's attacked. Good one, Phil. Yeah, rage quit. Yeah, fair play, he does them properly, doesn't he? Well, I think the group's come back together. Oh, no, Matt. Well, you're up north anyway, aren't you, Tom? You're up in Durham now, aren't you? Fair play, good win. Was it on the weekend or the weekend before? I think it was the weekend. Go on there. Big old long climb, fair play. Yeah, true, Tom, true. Tom won a hill climb on the weekend, guys. Following in my footsteps. Well, I'm saying that I've won one hill climb this year. Okay. Time to get a bit serious. Poor Moss. Ugh. Okay, here we go. Slipping, it's breaking up a lot. Yeah, it's not over yet. It's that Zwift physics that'll get us. I'm a hemorrhage sign on here. See how high my heart rate is? Also freshness is, guys. Right there. Three versus climber. I'm not a climber. Irony. I'm not. I just happen to be light with a high FTP. You better be hitting that thumbs up button. I'm like struggling. The heart rate is so high. It's so rare for me. Hopefully the three guys will look at each other. The like is for the effort, not for the win. Concentrate. Focus. Easy. Sam, let's go. Can I say, one thing that's got really difficult to manage now that I'm like absolutely dropping down the Training Peaks fitness charts is that my freshness, oh my word, absolutely like wreaks havoc on my lungs. You know, like the Pursuiter's cough, they call it, where you've gone like really hard for a really short space of time. It's like a VO2 max effort, basically. That's what I get nearly every time I go out training now, because I'm constantly trying to improve this thing. That's why my heart rate's so high as well. It still drops fast, but I like to say my heart rate's very active. It likes to do a lot of things, like... anyway, if you're new here, please hit that thumbs up button if you enjoyed this, because it helps more people see it as well. And I think the more people we can watch it, the more people... the more people can get the benefit from it and seeing how to, I don't know, you know, even if you're B cat or C cat, you can still learn a few things from the effort. So, anyway, are we going to guess the TSS? That's something that we do now, guess the TSS, and then we're going to have a look at the power profile. Oh, my chamois, well, this is the Lacolle indoor cycling kit, well, specifically the shorts. Anyway, the shorts have, I don't know if you can see these tiny little holes, you might be able to see them, I don't know. They go kind of all the way up the front of the quad and around the back, but not all the way around. They kind of end kind of where your lower back is, so yeah. Does actually really help, like, you know, this part of my leg is not sweaty, the back is, but the front isn't, and also it helps the fan when it hits me, to hit my, cool my quad. Why use the aero there instead of here? Just a speed thing, basically, so I'll use the aero at the top of the climb, just to give me that speed. But also it's like mentally as well, like if I had the aero coming down the descent and then kind of came around, you know, onto the flat, like I'd use it, but at that point mentally I'm committed, so I don't want to be like messing around. So at the top of the climb I was committed, I mean you all saw that anyway, so by being committed it takes away like any need to do anything else. So I didn't want to be like, you know, pressing the aero button or the power up button, like I didn't want to be doing that. I just wanted to get the power up out of the way and done. I mean, it would have benefited me there anyway, but would have benefited me anywhere. But I just wanted to get it done another way so I could just dig in. So, okay, a lot of you saying a couple of good TSS guesses there. So let's see what we have. Who is closest? 47 TSS. Oh, Mark Bentley, you had a 50 there, sir. Anyone else? Oh, Stuart, 45. That was pretty close. Fair play, guys. Good job. And quick look at the power graph. It was a really good effort, actually. Like, I was surprised. So I put in the initial effort up the climb, I shoot straight up to like 180 and I managed it really well, and then obviously dug in as hard as I could over the top, because I think Beck, it's difficult to say, but like Beck put in like a really good effort to hold the gap, and then he tried to bridge it then on that last section. I don't know if you any of you saw that. And when Beck kicked to try and close that gap at the end, I jumped across. Well, he was jumping across, but I jumped up that climb to try and like create that gap, because 3 seconds was nothing, 3 or 4 seconds was nothing, and I just needed to do like one massive effort to break that. So obviously the feather helped as well, but I was pretty confident that I, as long as I had a big enough gap there, then holding off the line would have been like a pretty, not easy thing to do, but a little bit easier. So yeah, and that's it. So I hope you enjoyed. If you're new, yeah, the zone one really does help, like feck. I didn't mean to break you mentally and physically. Actually, I almost did a new best 2.5 minute power. Actually, right here. 2:42. I set a new 2:42 power, so let me go back. Look, you know, that's what you made me do. So chapeau. Chapeau. I was going pretty hard there. Going pretty hard, so but it was a good effort, fair play. Sorry Robin, you'll have to come back next Tuesday for the racing. See you then, Gus. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I appreciate your company this evening, and I'll see you all soon.